That was a cup tie, actually, everything in it, didn't it?
Well, I think, you know, for a neutral, it would have everything, I suppose. There was plenty of action, plenty of controversial incidents. And I've got to say that we are fortunate to have won the match. I'm not denying that. But you would see a fighting, determined, resolute Aberdeen team. We're not the fanciest team in the league at the moment, but that's 13 games without defeat. And we're hard to beat. We're competing very, very well. And I would say at the moment it's work in progress.
Couple of turning points to the game. I think the first of all, I don't know if you've seen it again, I don't think you should have had a corner kick that led to the first goal. And yet, of course, Motherwell have got it going and defended, you would say.
Yeah, I think that exactly. If the corner kick was an erroneous decision, you know, there's still plenty of time to recover from that. You know, you've got to defend the corner. Now, I would be upset if it was a wrong decision and the other team got a goal from it. So I can understand the disappointment, but I've had so much of it this season at Aberdeen that I can sympathise with that. But you've got to defend the corner, and they didn't do it as well as they should.
The one point, we got 2-0, Craig. I thought, you know, in the wake of the sending off, that game was over, and we'd wrap it up, and Motherwell showed incredible spirit, and you were hanging on a bit at the end.
Yeah, we were hanging on, but that's not surprising, and I think you surprised me by saying you thought it was all over, because whenever a team goes down to 10, and it's a cup tie, nothing to lose, and they're at home, they throw caution to the wind, and they take chances, and you saw the chances they took. Peter Pollock should have ran the ball into the goal, and it would have been 3-1, and then you wouldn't have been asking me the question. You'd have said, well... But I've got to say, we did not play well against 10, and I give great credit to Motherwell because they were exceptionally positive, a man short.
But you still showed a lot of, you know, adventure spirit going forward. We thought you might have locked the door, traditional Craig Brown sort of way.
No, I don't know where I've got that reputation.
Just Billy Dodds?
No, Billy's talking nonsense.
No change here then?
No, that's true. I mean, he is talking nonsense. I've never sent a team out to defend. I've always sent a team out with normally with two strikers at least. Two or three attacking players. You know, I've never said we're going out and playing other than all the time with the Scottish team he played, it was 3-5-2, and it was two up front, and great support from midfield to Billy Dodds. So, I mean, it's nonsense to say that I'm a defensive manager. I don't think any player that's played for me, and Billy, I don't think he would say that if he was asked face to face. Were you ever asked to go out and defend? And we played England at Wembley, and we didn't go to defend. We played Germany and Germany.
Anyway, this is not about Billy Dodds. The Aberdeen fans are listening to this, and what you've done is taken your team into semi-final. You've got a huge opportunity. You've the draw against Hibs. How do you fancy that?
Well, obviously anyone in the semi-final is a pleasure because we're delighted to be there, and it wouldn't matter who we played. I've got to be honest, to avoid Celtic again is probably good because Celtic are the best team in the country, and when they get one strong, I think without question they would beat anyone, and they've proved that. You can see that with their league position, you can see that in the cup today. So to have avoided Celtic is good, I suppose, but unless we improve on our performance today, we'll not get to the final, and the lads know that. They've been told that today wasn't good, but we've got to take into consideration we're playing an outstandingly fine Motherwell team with very few injuries, and we're playing starting with four teenagers and two best midfield players in the country, in my opinion, the young ones, under 20. We're hurting the game. Off comes Jack. Off comes Jack's got a head knock. He was feeling his legs numb, which was worrying me, but he's okay. The doctor's cleared them. And the young five has got a very badly swollen ankle. Now, I've got to say, Keith Ladley did not mean that. I know Keith Lasley. Keith Lasley, no way was that a deliberate attempt to injure a player. You know, it might have been, you know, it looked a wee bit naughty just, but, you know, I think it was a harsh decision, but I'm not complaining because I never complain about decisions that go against us, and that went, in actual fact, that went against us too, because it gave Motherwell the persecution complex, and down to 10 men, nothing to lose, let's go. So it wasn't a favourable decision to have Motherwell players sent off, although people would think that. And Lasley, the last man that, in my book that is a dirty player.
I thought I'd bring you in a more joyous mood after that one.
Oh, I'm delighted for the 2,153 Aberdeen fans. They deserve. They've travelled with us and have been disappointed too often. And, you know, we've been away from home this season. Some very good away performances and results. And they deserve it because the support we have is